where it will take you, you have got no option. Where it will take you, you have got no option. A lot of people today, they do say, take me higher, take me higher. There are a lot of higher, right? Mm. So where it will take you, you have got no option. When Jesus arrived at the funeral, he didn't say, take me to the pot, take me to the nightclub. He didn't say, take me to the butcher so that I may eat. He said, take me to the grave. Mm. How strong are you to go to the grave? Take me to the grave. So if you are a prophet or a prophetess, you need to understand that you are a man or woman of declaration. Where is it going to take you? A lot of people, they do quote Ezekiel 37, which I want us to talk about today. The Bible says, the Spirit of the Lord took Ezekiel to the dry bones. It didn't take him to the dry food or dry fish. No. It took him to the dry bones. He was the only person there. Then he was asked, son of man, can these dry bones come back to life? If the Spirit has never taken you to a dangerous place, think twice. The Lord has not yet started using you. There are places the Spirit of God has been taking us. I went to heaven several. I went to hell. And God showed me the places. You may be thinking, maybe, as God will be using me as memory, I'm going to go to America. You find yourself going in Chibuni. Sometimes, God cannot take you where you want. Can take you where you don't want, like Jonah. He diverted. As he was diverting, the Bible says, the wind rose. And people began to suffer. You know that you can be the cause of suffering of other people. You have got no option where the Spirit will take you. It takes you to the club where people are having sex and tells you, begin to preach, but don't observe. You have to be preaching. Repent when you forget. Repent. John the Baptist, the Spirit of God took him to the wilderness. Jesus, the Spirit of God, took him to be tempted by the devil in the wilderness, 40 days, 40 nights. And the devil came. If you are the Son of God, command that stone to turn into bread. He knew that Jesus can do it. But Jesus could not do it because it was the command of the devil. Where the Lord will take you, I have no option. You will be thinking, maybe, I'm Patricia, I'm the evangelist, I'm going to go to UK. Yes, you can go to UK, but you end up sitting in Chihuahua. Or in Peps. Behind the Peps. You have money, a lot of money, want to build a big house. God will tell you that you love me. Build my house, not your yours. You just build it. Vomited. Then start living there. If you love me. Jesus was born in the manger. That's where he was born. Yet he had money. He said, God and silver belongs to me. Where God is taking you, I've got no option. That's the reason why somebody said, I have to go and bury my father. He had the option. He said, let the dead bury the dead. In this case, you've got no option. A lot of people have got a lot of options. So as God is taking me to America, I've seen the word man like this, you have got beard like this. Yeah, when you reach there, you become blind like Paul. Because he knows that your eyes may be an obstacle to the gospel. So if you love women, you love men when you go to America. You blind you. When you walk out of America, you see. When you go, you become blind. Paul said, I pray 3 times that God should remove the thorns of the devil. Then God said, I won't. Moses said, I'm unable to speak well. He said, I want. With your chibuibu, I'm going to do it with you. There are things God cannot take them out of us. God knows that if Patrick is to be counting videos, Patricia's memories will be garbage to him. So he has to remain poor so that he may teach them. As I'm teaching you, God is teaching me life as well. Messages comes because of you. Maybe as he was taken, Ezekiel thought, I'm going to heaven. He's going to the table. You got the point, yeah? The Bible says, deny yourself. Give yourself as a living sacrifice. You have got no option. Abraham, you have got no option. Yes, you're only. Or 5 years, you said, but. Let me look at it. He told Abraham that he Ishmael went. He didn't know where Ishmael went. Then God said, now, because if Ishmael was there, Abraham had an option of Ishmael. He could have said, Ishmael, I've got Ishmael, so I can offer him. Mm-hmm. Where God is taking you, I'll be married to a white. And you find somebody black coming to you. Then God said, yes, is the one. God, though you are crying, those are tears of joy, is the one.
The one.
That's the reason why. Never pray, let your will be done. Me, I don't pray that. You have got your will as well. You said the will. Now, who knows that the will of God is to give you somebody whose name? Who's that going to pray? So, speak your will. The Bible says, ask anything in my name, I shall do it. When you begin to ask his will, he thinks that, you are thinking in some ways. God, he thinks that you don't know what to ask. So, he gives you everything. Anything. Vindu vina mfane vantwari na akulero. It is because they say let your will be done. Iwe, we are mungu siwa. You know the will of God. The will of God was Jesus prayed, God, let it pass by. What? You have to die. In heaven, we agreed that you are going on earth to die. You have got no option. You can drop the option at school, but you cannot drop compulsory. You know that?